Stay cool.
This is a Thor News presentation. Hit the button, baby.
Stay cool.
Thor News presents.
Welcome to another wonderful Thor News economic update. Just kind of letting you in on my own personal thoughts. And you may say, hey, Thor, why should I listen to anything you have to say about finance and economics? And well, for a couple years now, I've been saying, hey, dude, every time they go, hey, we might raise interest rates, we might not. I go, they're not gonna, and then they don't. So I look like a total genius. Anyway, so I stick by that prediction. The next time they discuss raising interest rates, they're not gonna do it. And you'd think one day I'd be wrong, right? I know, me too. Anywho, so maybe I just got that one luckily crazily right. The other day, a guy on Twitter accused me, an actual professional screenwriter. I forget his name, Giuseppe DeLupe or something. He's like, you said the stock market was going to crash in September. Ha ha. And I was like, no, man, the title of the video was actually Four Reasons for a September Market Crash. And I laid out the four reasons why I thought a market crash was possible in September or October or November or December. Basically, the oil crapped the bed. Gold peaked in 2011, midpoint between 2008, the last crash, and about now. China's markets were melting, and the Dow Jones was at about 18.2 and had fallen to about 17,000 at the time. So I said, if I were you, I'd take your money out until 2016 and then decide then. I doubt it's just going to jump up instantly. Right now, it's at about 16-something, so technically, you would have made money. Right, that's where we're at. And if you have all this crappy shit going on in the economy, you'd think at some point, hey, man, there has to be some type of a correction in the markets because they've been drunk and at the punch bowl far too long and basic fiscal physics. Basic financial physics, right? Wrong. Now they're just kind of holding steady. And some players, like me and PIMCO and others, believe that they will have to announce quantitative easing 4. They're basically chasing inflation and interest targets as like the compounding interest grows on things, so too must the monetary base go, I believe, or something like that. So they're just going to keep printing money. And like all the countries are slowly devaluing their currency at the same time. It's a pretty odd ballet, by the way. And if you screwed up too bad, you could start World War III, where we've been pressuring the ruble. The ruble's been going down, along with the oil hit. Russia's been getting hit hard. Venezuela's been getting hit hard. A lot of places have been feeling pain, except for the stock markets, man. Which is pretty weird. But we have been using a lot of our focus, all of our energy, and about $5.5 trillion propping those stock markets up, right? Okay, so I discussed any news? No, not yet. Okay, so let's go into the news. Oh, the big news was Bloomberg reported, breaking news, the trade deficit has grown the most in 5 months. And a trade deficit is kind of like you have a balance as the country, America. We sell other countries X amount of goods, and then we buy X amount of goods. And a trade deficit is where we're buying a lot more goods from other countries than we are selling. We used to be an industrial nation where we built cars, clothes, a little bit of everything. And when Wall Street kind of took over and outsourced everything, and profit became the new god in America, man, we just started shipping off all the real good jobs and craftsmen careers. So that's where we're headed. So yeah, the exports are going to get slowly worse. But that is not a good sign. Another sign is American Apparel has filed for bankruptcy. Symbolically, hey, dude, America's clothes, the shit America wears, was like, hey, we're out of here. We're done. We can't handle this anymore. Apparently, that CEO is a dick who'd like to stick his finger in women's butts as they walk by or something. Wait, I made that up. That's not true. I don't slander anybody. I just saw allegations of misconduct, and that was the first thing I saw in my mind. Just some CEO guy walking, sticking his finger in a woman's butt. It's, you know, she's wearing a dress. It wasn't like she's naked or nothing, but it would still be rude. Wouldn't you agree? Okay. They filed for Chapter 11. And the one thing is, when I was learning about stocks and stuff, like I think they're called Momos. They're just like the emotional, like everybody's doing great. This is the, it'll go up the highest, it'll fall the fastest, like your clothing, your trendy clothing stocks, like yoga clothes and, you know, like Abercrombie and Fitch, that when like GE will drop 2%, those companies will drop like 8% when all the markets are falling. Did I explain that right? I don't know if I did. I didn't write this video out, so the structure of it's just going to be all over the place. Another, on a global level, Volkswagen had a giant scandal. Hey, dude, did you hear? Volkswagen had a giant scandal. Their stock crashed because apparently they were rigging Volkswagen emission data. And I was like, wow, it never occurred to me. Wow, it never occurred to me that you could rig carbon emission data to fit your own purpose for a profit. That is wild. You know, that's wild. Science can do that? That's crazy, man. You know, literally, I had some scientists involved. Because it was just like Frank who puts on the tires going, hey, dude, yeah, the emissions are fine. I don't think anybody's going to believe Frank. Oil's been spiking up, but that's a mirage. That's markets being moved. Oh, what else? Yeah, our national debt's out of control. Interest rates are still zero, like I said. We're still spending money like drunken sailors in Vegas who are under the impression they'd won $100 quadrillion. And here's my ultimate guess. Right now, it could go either way. It could crash up or crash down. Or we could have World War III. Like if we just saw like a 4,000-point spike in the markets, that would be bad. But I do believe that they will announce quantitative easing 4, and if they do, then it is time to buy stocks. Well, then technically the time would be to buy stocks now, but they'd have to have a reason to just say, okay, we're going to pump another $3 trillion into the markets. Saying that nobody wants to buy all our treasuries and our bonds isn't something we would do, so they'd have to have some other reason. So it's almost like you'd have to have a crash to have the reason to announce the QE4. I guess ultimately like, they just let this stay at around 16 for a while. Who knows, man? Are you ready for the October surprise? Well, me neither. Nobody's ever ready. Except the people who planned it, I guess. Alright, I hope that helped. I hope it made a little sense. I hope you had a little fun. Maybe it didn't. Okay, whatever, man. Talking about economics, fiscal stuff. At least I didn't stick my finger in your butt while you were wearing a dress like that one CEO guy. Just kidding. Man, I'm an idiot. Okay. Yeah, don't take economic advice from me. I'm an idiot. But did I give any advice? No, I think I just said pay attention. And World War III. It's fucking scary. Airstrikes. Arguing over airspace. Syria. Wow. Crazy days indeed. Let me hear science say that's not a bad omen. They're not going to do that.